Socialist countries centralize the payment and delivery of goods and services. In healthcare, the model of centralization is a single-payer system. Support for single-payer healthcare is driven by a simple concept. The government guarantees medical care for everyone, while using its size and purchasing power to keep costs low. But in practice, it turns out that single-payer systems are making a false promise. Medical care is overtly restricted for everyone except those who can afford to go outside the system. To contain costs, single-payer systems limit the availability of doctors, treatments, medications, and technology. The result is the ultimate cost imposed on societies that use single-payer healthcare. Worse outcomes from diseases, more deaths, and more disability. One specific example is the limited availability of life-saving cancer drugs in single-payer systems. Time is of the essence with cancer, because earlier access to new treatments saves lives. Of the world's 54 new cancer drugs launched from 2013 to 2017, 94% were available in the United States after 2 years, compared to 70% in the United Kingdom, 53% in Canada, and only 43% in France. Cancer drugs are far more likely to be developed and first become available in the United States than in countries with single-payer systems. It is no surprise that the U.S., with its freer markets, has the world's best outcomes from cancer. This overt restriction of care is also seen in delaying access to important surgeries, restricting diagnostic technology, and limiting the number of critical care beds and services. The overall costs to society of single-payer healthcare are enormous, far beyond the taxes required to support such a system.